But it means to be submissive like a slave. The deacons also acted as secretaries and treasurers to the bishop. They were the right-hand men, representing them in all secular matters. A deacon shall have the authority to teach and conduct worship service, to assist an elder in administering the Lord's Supper, provided this authority is given to him by the appointed pastor in charge. So a deacon's position is not a called position, it is an appointed position. So the pastor can appoint or disappoint. The Bible now, when you look in Acts, it was different than the deacon in Timothy. Acts, the Bible told the men of God to look out among you and find you seven men full of the Holy Ghost. It didn't say anything about whether they were married or the man of one wife or any of that. But it said, look out among you and find seven that are filled with the Holy Ghost. But rather than reading all of that, you can do that in your own time. I believe it's 1 Timothy chapter number 3, verse 8.
Likewise, must the deacons be grave, not double-tongued,
yes,
not given too much wine,
yes,
not greedy of filthy lucre,
yes,
holding the mystery of the faith in a pure conscience,
yes,
and let these also first be proved,
yes,
then let them use the office of a deacon,
yes,
being found blameless.
Now, one of the words that it means that he must be honest and honorable. It does not mean that he haven't made mistakes in life. It talks about him not being double-tongued. You ain't going to like everything the pastor say. You ain't going to like everything anybody say. You ain't going to agree with everything anyone say. And everyone ain't going to agree with everything you say. But when you're not double-tongued, in other words, he said that you are seasoned enough to say, and I learned this the hard way. I learned that before I became a pastor, I didn't understand everything my pastor said. And sometimes I would say, you don't have my own opinion. But when I became a pastor, I realized that I didn't understand everything because his vantage point is different than mine. And sometimes, you know, your children don't understand you until they have children. Then they begin to understand certain things that, amen, you told them. But he's not going to be double-tongued and drinking. And now, back in the Bible days, they drunk a little wine because the water was contaminated. And you read when he talked about Samson, no razor should touch his head, and he should not drink strong drink. This was, amen, what was given to Samson's mother. And what was said was that the longer the wine set, the more fermented or the stronger it got. But we don't drink wine. Because if you've been where we've been, say amen. Amen. Well, yeah, one is too many and a thousand is not enough. Say amen. We don't drink because I'm going to tell you about me, pastor, ain't going to take a little drink. I'm going to get drunk. Y'all ain't talking. But we don't do that. And I believe that, amen, because of the infilling of the Holy Ghost, that God now has changed his life. I believe that he's really trying, amen, to live saved. That's all any of us are doing, isn't that right? And that word grave means to be honest and honorable.
Yes.
And since I've been here, that's all that I've seen concerning this man, to be honest and honorable. He's helped me. He's helped other people here in the church, and so we want him, amen, to be raised up in ministry. Somebody clap your hands for that. But for as much as you have been selected to serve as a deacon, and you have declared before God and man your willingness to serve your office well, do you wholeheartedly, Brother Charles White, and with consistent cooperation of all the members of this church, tried by the will of the Almighty God to do your duty.
I do.
Do you promise to honor God and your church in your services, behavior, and conduct?
I do.
The great task, and this is for the congregation, thrust upon this man now before us cannot be done alone. He has promised by the help of God to serve his office well.
Yes.
But his best effort will fail without the wholehearted and consistent cooperation of all the members of this church. Don't give him a hard time. You ought to not play with officers in the church.
Amen.
There's a difference between playing and having fun.
That's right.
I remember the time, no matter if you were a bishop, a pastor, a preacher, or a deacon,
that's right,
that preacher and that deacon were two of the most highest held officers in the church. They were well respected.
That's right.
Because there were offices where you had to be trustworthy.
That's right.
Do you, the members of the Lily of the Valley, accept and receive Brother Charles Wright as your duly elected deacon?
I do.
Do you promise to give him respect, honor, and encouragement to which his office is entitled?
I do.
If so, will you stand and say amen? Come on, say amen again. Come on, clap your hands as you say amen. You may be seated, congregation. Then I declare by the power, the will of God, and this congregation by the power that's been invested in me by the Church of God in Christ worldwide, you are to serve as duly selected deacon and be the rich blessings of God. And may his grace be upon you, and may you enjoy the confidence and the support of your brothers and sisters, and not let us, amen, fight against you, amen, but let us unite our hearts as we pray for this deacon and consecration every day. Father, in Jesus' name, we look to you now as you elevate this man of God, and many times a new title determines you to be a new target. But we cover him with the blood of Jesus, the matchless Lamb of God. We pray, God, that he will just take earnest and sincerity the office that he's in right now, that he will study and pray and seek your face on how he can be better at what you're calling him to do. Let his life touch the life of someone else. Let what he says and does be done in excellence, and not just to be seen of men, but to be honored and smiled upon by God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. We bind every spirit that will come against him, but in Jesus' name. Somebody help me say, but in Jesus' name. But in Jesus' name, we anoint him. In Jesus' name, we cover him. Strengthen his body, add days to his life, that he will be able to serve with his pastor and first lady and the leaders of this church, that he will live to be a ripe old age. And we count it done in the name of Jesus. Come on, preachers, lay hands on him. We fortify, we cover with the spiritual armor. Come on, deacons, lay hands. Teaches that after Jacob had wrestled with an angel, that his name was changed, and that God gave him favor with man and with God. And today he's no longer just a brother, but he is a deacon in the church of God in Christ. Would you say to God praise as I present to you, amen?